Hello everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to explain how to use BibLaTeX style file for generating bibliographies in your LaTeX documents. The package documentation for BibLaTeX runs to 347 pages. Therefore, it may not be possible for me to give all the provisions, all the facilities, all the options that is available in BibLaTeX. However, to the extent possible, I will try my best to introduce maximum number of options that a normal LaTeX user may use. One important point is, though BibLaTeX has got many advantages, it has got a major disadvantage. I will discuss this disadvantage at the end of this video and also provide a solution to it. Let us say we start with the Technique Center editor. Here we have document class article, and then I use a package with certain options, BibLaTeX. Now to compile this, we have to follow a three-step process. First, we have to compile this with PDF LaTeX. That is, in Technique Center, we have to use LaTeX to PDF. And then, we have to compile it again with Biber. Once again, we have to compile with LaTeX to PDF. We have to use PDF LaTeX. However, I am using Aurora with directives like this. First directive is PDF LaTeX, second directive is Biber, third directive is PDF LaTeX. If you are familiar with Aurora, this will be very convenient. If you are not familiar with Aurora, kindly refer to my previous video on how to use Aurora in LaTeX documents. Now, with Aurora, we can say with this single command, we can follow these three compilations one after another. First PDF LaTeX, then Biber, once again PDF LaTeX. We get the output like this. Because we have given here, after begin document, we have got table of contents. Therefore, we have contents line. And then in the end, we have print bibliography. With PDF LaTeX, we have to follow certain important conditions, namely, first, the package, load the package itself with the certain options. I am loading it with an option sorting none. No sorting is required. Then, if we say sorting is none, then whatever may be the order in which we have got the entries in the bib file will be the order in which we have the output. For example, in bib file, the LaTeX companion will be the first bib item, and then this will be the second bib item, and so on. Then we have to use the command add bib resource. If you remember, with BibTeX, we say simply bibliography, and then we give the bibliography file name without the extension .bib. But here it must be explicitly given. Third one will be the command print bibliography. This command is useful when we want to print the bibliography itself in the output. Now we have got, with the print bibliography, we have references. I have not cited any of these references in the text. I will come to it a little later. Therefore, for BibLaTeX, we have to follow three steps. Load the package itself, use package BibLaTeX with certain options. Second item will be add bib resource, and then third one will be print bibliography. With this, we have this output. Now, if you see, in the first case, only first author is available in the output, all other authors are abbreviated as yet al and others. Now, suppose we say max bib names is 6. I have seen some authors using 99 for max bib names. You can use any number. I use 6. In that case, you will find for the first reference 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 authors are listed. All the 5 authors are listed here. Then, if we say given units true, then we will have Frank abbreviated as F dot, Michael abbreviated as M dot, and so on for all others. Again, if we say terse units true, then what will happen is I show this item once again after compilation. I comment this out. Look at the 11th bib item, J dot, hyphen P dot, etc. And then second author is I dot, R dot, etc. I say terse units true. Then we will have the period and the hyphen etc. removed, including the space between any two consequent initials, JP here and IR here. Similarly, in the first case, previously it was F dot, here M dot, J dot, etc. Although all of them were removed. Now, let us take the case of the reference 10. It has got digital object identifier, DOI, ePrint, URL, etc. Suppose you say DOI is false, ePrint is false, URL is false. If it has got ISBN, let us say it is false. Then this portion will be removed from the output. Now, let us consider the sorting now. Sorting, when we say sorting is none, entries appear in the order in which they appear in the bibliography file. When you do not say anything, what I mean to say is, if you comment this out, it is equivalent to saying that sorting order is NTY, first name and then title and then year. Let us see this. I compile this. The first item was previously Mittelberg. Now it is according to alphabetic order, you can see. Because sorting order is first according to name. One important point is, when I say it is going to be sorted in this way, first name and then title and then year, I don't mean to say first you will have the name and then the title and then the year. It is not so. When we take subsequent items in the reference list, the sorting will be done first by name, then by title, and thirdly by year. NYT. First you can have name, and then second sorting is done by year, third sorting is done by title. Similarly, other things are also possible. In particular, you may be interested in this. If you want to have the years appearing in descending order, then you have to use YDNT. Similarly, other cases also possible. Now, let us take up other cases. Let us see how to print the bibliography with a title different from references. One method is to give title in the option brackets, in square brackets like this, then references will change to the value that we have given. This is one method. Another method is, you can also say, define bib heading. You use some name. Let us say I am using custom bib. Then here you can say print bibliography, heading is custom bib. Then what we have given there will appear in the output. Now I am using here a selection type, an option type. That means in the bibliography file, only those items which he has got at bib, let us say like this, at book, alone will be selected and outputted. Let us see now. Only books. We have also used heading is sub bib in toc. Therefore, you find in the contents line books only also appearing with a page number. Now, you can also output based on the keyword major. That means you should have used the field keywords here. Here it is plural, whereas in the tech file it is singular. Keywords can be more than one. You can use major, minor, etc. I want to output only those bib items which have the keyword major. Also, you can say not keyword. That means all bib items which do not have the keyword major in them will be outputted. Now, in the third case, I use keyword minor. Let us see. You find books only, major resources, and then minor resources. Now, suppose you want to correct these numbers. If you want to have them serially, 1, 2, 3, etc., what you can do is, you can have an option, defer numbers true. When you defer numbers true, you will find the numbers will be 1, 2, 3, etc. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. Now, here we have said pre-note is XXX and post-note is YYY. Already we have defined what we mean by XXX. Def bib note. I say this is a text at the beginning of the bibliography, and the def bib note YYY is something else. Pre note will appear immediately after the title, just before the bib items, the references, and this will appear at the end of the list of references. If you want, you can use this option also. Once you know these things are possible, let me stop only with the simple standard references. Now, we have got them arranged in the numbered format because style has been given as a numeric. You can also have author year type. Style can be author year. Instead of numeric, let us say you have author year, and then you can have the references as per listed as per the authors and years. All you can also have APA style. This is APA style. Again, you can have MLA style also possible. You find here the title is changed to works cited. Also, when the author names are repeated, you have here a long line. Then you can also have physics as a style. Then you will find the numbers in superscripts and volumes are in bold. Volumes are appearing in bold like this. Now, what are other styles possible? Number of them are available. When you say numeric, as the name itself implies, it will be arranged in the form of, it will be given in the form of numbers, 1, 2, 3, etc. When you say numeric compact, then 1, 2, 3 will appear as 1n-3. Numeric verbose will be explicitly given like this, or alphabetic, alphabetic verbose, author year, etc. These are all available styles. And one special style is what is known as reading. You can see the references like this. Here you have the bib label ref7, ref11, etc. Or another style that is available is debug. When you have this option, I made a mistake somewhere. Toy is undefined. Okay. You find all the references in the bibliography file are presented in the form of a table. This is the first reference, let us say with the bib label ref7, and then you find here so many details about that reference. Let me take one special case. Now, the title is the /LATEX/companion. I will show you. The title is like this. Now, if you want to use this for sorting, then articles A and D should not be used for sorting. Therefore, index title will be different. LaTeX companion, comma, the, and then index sort title will be capital L A cap all caps. Therefore, this will appear as a first item. For the purpose of sorting, we use index title, index sort title, etc. Now, for every bib item you can have. In the bibliography, we have got 11 bib items. Therefore, this is available in 11 pages. Now, let us consider the simple type, numeric. Here we have got the numeric style of listing of the references. The specialty of bib LaTeX is you can list the references in the numeric form, but you can cite them in author year form. We have used nat bib equal to true. In that case, what you can have is, I take one special case of citation, foot cite. When you say foot cite, then Here you have superscript 1. As a footnote, you find the list, the reference. That is useful if you want to have footnotes like this. Or you have two commands, param site and site p. Then they will be identical. Param site and site p will be identical. However, there is a subtle difference. Param site star and site p star are different. Param site star produces only the year, whereas site p star outputs the entire details like this. Now, you can also have site T. Site T is used so that the author list forms part of the sentence. A peculiar command that is available with the BibLaTeX is cites. Now, let us consider the bib label ref1. It has got a post note 380. For ref2, it has got a postfix 12 and prefix also. In addition to that, both of them can have a pre note which is empty and a post note and chapter 3. Let me compile and show you the result. Now see, in the first case, ref1, this postfix is available as p.page 380, semicolon. And then, for ref5, we have Ravi Kalidas and Srinivasamurthy. Prefix is also, postfix is 12. Prefix is also, and postfix is available as p.12. For both of them, notice a comma here. For both of them, pre-note is empty and post-note is and chapter 3, blah. Then there is a small problem. Suppose you are not using this slash. And the next, we start with a square bracket. It will produce an error. You can see the paragraph ended before this runaway argument. It stops here. Therefore, if you do not have the square bracket, compilation will go on without any problem. If you have a square bracket, you must necessarily have a backslash here. Only then compilation will be all right. Now, the difference between BibTeX and BibLaTeX is the number of fields that we can use in the case of BibLaTeX bibliography files are too many. We have got so many fields possible in the bib file. Keywords, etc., etc. So many of them are possible. But with BibTeX, they are not. It is not so. Having said that, though there are many advantages, seemingly many advantages with BibLaTeX, there is a major disadvantage with BibLaTeX files. Namely, journals normally do not prefer to have BibLaTeX file because they have developed in-house tools to deal with BibTeX. They don't want to change over to BibLaTeX all on a sudden. However, there are two methods by which we can overcome this. Namely, first method is immediately after BibLaTeX loading, you load another package, BibLaTeX to BibItem. And then here you say print BibItem bibliography. I comment this out. Print BibItem bibliography. Now, you will find in the output references, you have starting with begin the bibliography, going up to end the bibliography, you have the complete list. You can find the formatting commands also. All that you have to do is copy the whole thing from the PDF file, starting from begin the bibliography up to end the bibliography, paste it in your tech file. Comment out all these things, just paste them in the tech file and submit it to the journal. This is one method. Second method is compile the original document as usual using Viper, assuming that your tech file is article.tech, then you will get a file article.bcf. Then if you want to have a bib file containing only the cited references, then use this command in the command prompt: Viper 2- output --- format equal to bibtag article.bcf. You will have an output file which will be available in this format: article_viper.bib. Enter article_viper.bib as a bib resource instead of your full library in the article tech. What I mean to say is, here instead of using original bib file, you will use this article_viper.bib as a resource. Then send this bib file also along with the other files to the journal. Then there will be no problem. Then if you wonder how to have chapter wise or section wise bibliography, that is also possible with BibLaTeX. All that you have to do is, you say ref segment equal to part or chapter or section or subsection, one of them, not all of them, just one of them. Let us say you want to have bibliography for every part of your book. In that case, suppose you say ref segment is part, then immediately after the part command, you have to say begin ref segment, and then at the end of the part you have to say end ref segment. Before end ref segment, you have to say print the bibliography. You have to say print bibliography segment 1 heading sub bibliography. Similarly, for every part you have to do it. With this, we complete our discussion on BibLaTeX. We will continue in another video a little later. Thank you all very much for watching. Thank you very much.